In the week that went by, this piece of news outraged conservationists all over the globe. Yes, almost 500,000 sharks can be killed in a bid to make vaccines for COVID-19. According to Shark Allies, a non-profit organization, sharks are harvested for a compound known as squalene, which is used in vaccines. So mass production of COVID vaccine in coming years may spell doom to the shark population, which is already on decline. But before you get upset, there is one more animal. The horseshoe crab, whose blood is routinely harvested by the biomedical industry for a compound called Limulus amebocyte lysate. Even this species' life may be in danger, again in our pursuit of a COVID-19 vaccine. This is especially significant as world leaders assembled this week, most via video conferencing, for the UN Biodiversity Summit, where they pledged to rise to the contemporary ecological challenges. But will these promises translate into tangible actions in their home countries?
The combined forest and tree cover by 15,000 square kilometer to reach nearly 25%. We now have the highest number of tigers, the Asiatic lions, and we have also launched Project Dolphins.
India's Environment Minister Prakash Javadekar spoke at the summit outlining India's rich biodiversity and how the country aims to increase its forest cover. But the devil is in the details. Tigers are being threatened by mining while forest land is turning into plantations in India. Lions in Gujarat are dying from various viral and protozoan infections, including the deadly canine distemper virus. And the government has refused to translocate despite the Supreme Court order. To top it all off, the draft EIA notification has cast shadows of doubt on the government's commitment to preserving the environment and biodiversity. If you would like to know in detail about the draft notification and the problems with it, please watch the video we made earlier. The link is in the description. According to the 5th Global Biodiversity Outlook report, none of the 20 targets that were agreed by national governments in Aichi Prefecture in Japan have been reached. Six of them have been partially achieved. One of them, saving the coral reefs, the world seems to be moving in the opposite direction and so in controlling pollution levels. All these targets come under five main strategies outlined in the Aichi Convention on Biodiversity. These include bringing biodiversity issues into the mainstream, reducing the pressure on biodiversity, safeguarding biodiversity by ensuring genetic diversity, among others. We have provided a link for the report in the description that you can take a look. With respect to national goals, the countries are doing slightly better, with 34% saying that they are either on track to meet the targets or have exceeded expectations. India too had said that it was on track in 2018. When the report was released early September, indicating that none of the global 20 targets were achieved, around 64 countries and the European Union immediately responded by pledging stronger environmental protection in the coming 10 years. However, US, China, India, Russia, and Brazil have not signed this pledge. Interestingly, all these countries are led by authoritarian leaders or leaders with authoritarian tendencies. They are also among the countries worst affected by the COVID-19. As Brazil's Bolsonaro lets the Amazon burn, Trump reverses his predecessor's environmental protection laws, and Javadekar dilutes the EIA, the relationship between the pandemic and the necessity to protect the environment becomes clearer. Experts are already predicting that we are entering the age of pandemics. As the forest cover decreases, the interaction between humans and wild animals increases, leading to zoonotic diseases like COVID-19 and Karnataka's very own Kasanur forest disease. With COVID-19 pushing us towards one more ecological disaster by harvesting the body parts of sharks and crabs in the name of vaccines, a summit like this becomes increasingly significant. At least, it reminds us of the coming war and the tangible goals that, if achieved, may save us all from our own doom.